So, the wife decided she wants to put a bookshelf in downstairs, and this was going to become my office space. So I started to get to work on a plan. Now, what you see behind me is what used to be the desktop that I used to work on. It's an 80-inch by 36-inch door, but it was stabilized between two cabinets, so it was a static desk. What I'm doing now is I'm actually building a new desk on top of some risers, right? So this is an electric rising desk, so it becomes a sit-stand desk. I am going to be building into this desktop a computer. I've watched a lot of really great videos online. I love watching some of the DIY projects and was inspired. So wanted for a while to build a computer into my desk. This was a really great opportunity for me to do so. So this is the first of many snippets of video that will go into this project. So it's 12:15 in the morning. All the lumber's here. I've redesigned this thing twice during the course of this evening. Now the speakers, which are significantly larger than I originally expected. I ordered 5.5-inch speakers, and they have an 8-inch presence. So I had to redesign all of the layout of the plywood board. On the plus side, this actually gets back to a design that I originally had, which was to have an angled front for speaker mounting that would point to the person at the desk. Beyond that, trying to unwarp all the boards. So I had them in the bathroom, weighted down, trying to humidify them. Wish me luck. So I'm long overdue for an update. I spent good part of this weekend working on the new desk. And as you can see, the new speaker exactly as I expected. Now, that was after three trips to Lowe's and one trip to Home Depot, even this morning. I was able to get all of my cutouts perfectly set. And then I have an intake 120. It's going to be sitting right here at the front of the box. I was able to get a very nice little hole put in here. This is actually going to house the power button that'll be put in once I've gotten everything stained and everything. And of course, as you can see, those wonderful 8-inch speakers, which are far larger than what I originally intended. I did want to mention we had talked a little bit about how terribly warped these boards are. And as you can see, I had to actually use a number of brackets throughout the setup in order to pull boards together. So again, just brackets all over the place. It's very messy. It's not the way that I want it to be. As of right now, you can see I've just got my tower laying on its side in the main bay. I have to actually get, my job done. When I'm done, the expectation is that there will only be one cable that will still be visible leaving the computer. And that is going to be this one cable, which will be coming out down to the power. That one cable is actually running to an 8-plug battery UPC, which is actually inside of the frame as well. There will be no cables when I'm done with this process, except for the one cable coming from the UPC. Getting very close. And then obviously we still have to do staining, sanding, some more of that. I do have a custom piece of glass that is coming that'll be laying on the top here. Actually, you can probably see what I've done here is I've actually grooved in about a half inch on every single one of these boards. Very excited, very close. I would say I'm probably about a week out. So, new update. Once we have the glass, which is supposed to come in on Friday, we should be ready to start staining after we do the fit, make sure that everything looks good, we'll be in good shape. But new major update with a little bit of ingenuity, those bays will actually be protected by aluminum screen. But in order for this to actually work in a way that would make sense, what I did was I actually put in magnets because that's how you solve all the world's problems are magnets. One of the major considerations in this build is that I don't currently have USB access outside of removing the glass. Potentially putting in a bay of USB. Next update will be very soon. Okay, so latest update. We have now finished all of the staining of all of the wood, as you can see. Added in the trap door to be able to access the monitor mount. Still have an open cover at the top here, so this board still moves. All in all, pretty much everything at this point with the physical design is all done. Really, the only thing left to do is to actually place the computer itself inside the bay. Fortunately, it's now another Sunday night, which means that I need to get back to work tomorrow. Next weekend, to actually do all the mounting of the screws so that I can actually place all the CPU components. Overall, the desk actually looks exactly the way that I was hoping for it to look. So, we're in pretty good shape. It's taken far longer than I wanted to, but almost there. So this is that classic moment where you're not entirely certain you did everything right, but you're not entirely certain if there's anything you did wrong. So rewired all the componentry. I think I've done it correctly. Moment of truth. Let's plug in some cables. Okay, so what this tells me is that we've got essentially all the power is correct. My guess is if we're not getting anything to the GPU, it's because the riser cable is somehow not working. So now we're just in troubleshooting mode. You probably didn't notice before, but this cable before was black. I had a 4.0 cable that I had originally wanted to use, but it didn't actually fit with the mount. So we're gonna give it one more shot. Those monitors come on, we're in business. We can see the fans are spinning. We have a screen. I'm glad I bought the extra cable. Not gonna lie right now. And I am booted. At this point, the only thing that I have to do, obviously, is make some sense of all of this madness, but the project's largely done. And let me just show you one more thing. The finishing piece that I was waiting for to come in today, piece of tempered glass that lays over the entire bay. But this piece of glass is what allows for me to have a usable work surface, perfectly visible. And this is why cleaning up all of the cables and all of that stuff, it's going to be so important tomorrow. I built an entire computer inside of a desk, designed exactly how I want it, no cords, visible outside of the desk. The next video is going to be all of the cable cleanup. So, the day is finally here. It's pretty much done. I got a couple more things that I still gotta clean up, but let me show you what I've got here. I've got the speakers, which have been fantastic. I'll do a quick sound test on that in just a second. And as you can see, the computer is fully built and running. The glass panel worked out very perfectly, but all of the rest of the equipment is actually installed and set up and went to the store today, went to Micro Center and bought a whole bunch of cord management stuff, cable management stuff. So was able to get all this stuff cleaned up in a way that's actually like you can actually see what's happening inside of the case now. One thing that I will say, was not anticipating this, but I'm very excited about it. The temperature actually on my CPU with the new configuration. So I used to keep an eye on this, especially going into this project. I wanted to have a sense for kind of what the temperature experience was going to be like, right? So my guess was because it was going to be such a significantly larger case that it would probably decrease the temperature or the temperature experience of the CPU. But actually, the second part of that is this is actually likely to become a very hot spot, right? Because all of the power and then in addition to that, the subwoofer itself likely to increase the temperature. You know, that's still a lot of heat being generated inside the case that I expected would actually raise the temperature. But as you can see, I'm actually only hitting 35 degrees, 34 degrees Celsius, which is actually about 10 to 15 degrees cooler than what my old case was.
So I got you, Cooler Master. My case is cooler. We'll see how it goes for the next couple days, and thanks for joining me for the journey. And if you guys have any questions, happy to answer those. And if anybody's interested in talking about any of this stuff, happy to, provide any thoughts or insights that I can. And hopefully somebody else will take on a project and iterate and do better than I did. I expect that this is only going to be the first version of this task.
Last update. I do want to mention that I was able to put in the power button. So this is the only externally facing button in the entire system.
I almost forgot. Sound test. So I believe right now I'm running this at 25%. This is a track that I really, really enjoyed from the Us soundtrack. So let's give it a listen.